Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. So we know that the dry season is here and we have little to no rain. In fact, we've not had rain in about a week now, and I actually love how my plants are looking. I have a video here on my channel on things that you should grow now in the dry season. I have an outbreak of pests right now in my garden, although majority of my plants are still good, but I have a few of them that have been attacked by caterpillars mainly, and aphids and white flies. Are you going through pest problem right now in your garden like me? I feel like if I don't do anything right now, it's just going to spread in my garden, because this is the season. It comes with the season. So I need to take care of it now so that it doesn't go around my garden. In this video, I want to show you how to use baking soda, a very simple ingredient that you can get from your kitchen. I believe everybody has baking soda in their kitchen. So I want to show you how to use baking soda to control pests, and also use baking soda to prevent pests and disease in your garden, because you know, prevention is better than cure. You know, on this channel, we're all about using natural stuff, things that are safe for us, are considered safe for our plants as well. That's why I'm going to be using baking soda as the main ingredient in this mix. Baking soda is an available, effective, affordable and natural option for preventing and managing pests in the garden. So you need 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Add that to your 1 liter of water. Make sure that you're using a mild or diluted dishwashing soap. So if you already have pest problems in your garden, this particular mixture is for you. And if you're looking to prevent pests and disease from attacking your plants, then you need to watch out for the next baking soda mixture that I'm going to show you. We know that prevention is better than cure. So if you want to make sure that these pests and disease do not get to your plants, there is a separate mixture. Just watch till the end to see what I did differently with the second mixture for prevention. State of my lemon balm. First of all, cut out all affected areas. So we're going to do a lot of trimming here. A lot of trimming. And just so we can get all of these guys out, so we can actually propagate. These are some fresh leaves of the lemon balm, so I'm gonna take out this one so that I can propagate it. Okay, so I can make new plants with this one. Keep it aside and then do all of the trimming. You think this is the end of this plant because of how bad it looks, but this plant, trust me, has been through worse, and I keep bringing it back to life by trimming and spraying with baking soda mix. What you need to do is cut off all affected leaves, all affected stem, and then spray with the baking soda solution. So to prevent, instead of treating, you need to also do the same mixture, but this time around you're going to add vegetable oil to it. I'm using pig fat, but you can use vegetable oil. Oh my god, right here, I think I added more soap than I should have. I was just trying to eyeball it. Anyway, you get it. So you're adding the soap so that the oil and the water plus the baking soda can mix together.
This solution will prevent pest and fungal disease from attacking your plant if you spray it once every 2 weeks or once a week. Just be careful with baking soda though. You don't want too much in your soil. Anyway, so I'm going to add that to the spray bottle and use that to spray most of my plants, especially my existing plants that has not been attacked by pest or disease in any way. So I'm just using that to prevent them from attacking my plant. Apply this solution once a week or once in 2 weeks. I like to do it once in 2 weeks or once in 3 weeks because I do not want too much baking soda on my soil. In as much as it is safe for the plant, it helps the plant and also the soil, too much of it can also damage your plant and change the pH balance of your soil. Do not use this spray on seedlings. Why I love using baking soda is it is more effective if you're trying to prevent pest and disease from attacking your plants. And also, baking soda prevents fungal infection like powdery mildew, which attracts pests and weakens plants. So you may be wondering how baking soda works against pest and disease. I'm going to tell you. So baking soda raises the pH on plant surfaces, making it less conducive for fungi. Most fungi like powdery mildew and black spots thrive in acidic conditions. It works by preventing the fungal spores and creating a barrier. Baking soda can dry out the soft-bodied pests like aphids, mealybugs, and spider mites by absorbing their moisture. Baking soda will also neutralize over-acidic soil, helping it prevent root diseases caused by pathogens. So if you don't have any other thing for pest control, please try and make sure you have baking soda. I promise you, baking soda is one of the most effective pest control in terms of prevention, especially prevention, because prevention is, better than cure. So let me know if you have questions in the comment section and I will always be there to respond. I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed creating this video. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next video. And if you do not have baking soda, especially this dry season, please go and get it. It is very affordable. You can find it in the nearest shop, the nearest supermarket. You do not have to get it from a baking store. You can just walk into any supermarket and get your baking soda. Make sure you have baking soda in your pantry, okay?